Hey everybody, how are you? It's Brenda Adelman. This is day 23 of 30 Days of Forgiveness with Brenda. The first week was about forgiving yourself, which I think is the most important thing, because if you don't forgive yourself, you can't really forgive others, or you can forgive others to the extent that you've forgiven yourself. I feel like it's the same thing with love. We can love others as much as we love ourselves, right? So we want to feel whole, complete, present, so that we can apply loving to those parts inside of us that hurt, learn the lessons that we need to learn, and attract people into our lives that also love themselves. Because people who love themselves don't create havoc in other people's lives, right? Week two was about forgiving your mother. And it also applied to forgiving the feminine, the judgments we have against the feminine that often can be things like control, competitiveness, although that's masculine too, weakness. Those are qualities over the years, since I've been coaching since 2005, that are usually associated with moms or feminine. And so we want to heal those so that if those qualities are present within us, we can release them, we can love them and release them, never beating ourselves up. Or if those qualities are present in someone else, we identify them, but we don't judge them, right? Identify what we don't like and we can pivot. Or like weakness, we can look at the positive of that, which might be, the positive of weakness might be an energy of surrender. Some people think that's weak, but there's a lot of positive aspects of surrender. Hey, Cliff, missed you, I think, yesterday. And how are you today? Then week three was on forgiving. Good afternoon. Week three was on forgiving your father, or those qualities of the masculine that we judge over the years when I've worked with people. Oh, someone's just copying me. Let me see if I can. Actually, where can I invite someone here? Kristen. Oh, not there. Not sure. I know there's a way to invite people. Why am I not seeing it? Well, she will have to find the... I don't know. I'm not finding my invite link. Anybody know? Nope. I'm not seeing the invite. Oh, here's a plus. Live video. It's not giving me the option to invite people. How odd. Well, I'll invite her afterwards. Okay. To watch the replay. The technology is going to kick my ass today. It's already been kicking my ass. Oh, I know. I can possibly do it here. Let me, bear with me 1 second. If you want to share with me, Cliff, how your week is going, that would be awesome while I'm inviting someone to this group right now, a client. Let's see, Facebook. This is Forgiveness and Freedom. For those of you who are watching this on another place, I may have repurposed this too. I go live here every day. Today is 1:30 Pacific Standard Time. It is usually, let me see, Forgiveness and Freedom. It's usually 1 p.m., but I had a call with my clients in the Freedom Circle right before this. Okay, good. There we go. I'm not very good at multitasking. And I don't know why I can't see a place to invite people here, like a share sign or something like that. Cliff, oh, there you are. Okay. There's your comment from before. Okay, week three was on forgiving your father. A lot of the qualities with that are like abandonment, abuse. There's a harshness. And those are qualities, we want to forgive those qualities, or the judgments around the qualities, even if we don't want to embrace them, because the truth is we have everything within us. Like someone might say, I'm not abusive, but then look at how you abuse yourself with that negative voice. If you are putting it outside of you and not taking responsibility for how it actually takes place inside of you, you can't heal it, right? Okay, and then this week is about forgiving God. Well, hopefully she got that so she could come on down and see this live stream. So this has been quite a journey, and I talked about forgiving God yesterday. It's actually a pretty good pretty good video, and it's about how in times during our lives when we are feeling abandoned, well, let's say Cliff says Fridays aren't as exciting while we are still within lockdown. That's true as far as Friday nights, I would say. Friday is certainly a work day for me, but nothing is as exciting. I am doing a workshop. I did one last weekend, and I had so much fun with the people who were in there. So sometimes my work is fun, and I can still do it. I'm doing the best I can online. Even now, having this connection to me is better than just being in the house alone. So that's definitely more fun. This last weekend, we were producing videos. Everyone was producing videos, so it was super fun to watch all the breakthroughs. And for me, that's really creative, like being able to direct people. Whereas forgiveness is not as fun, I will say that. But I do like the connection. I wonder how much longer of this lockdown will be. I wonder, and then I just surrender, honestly, instead of wanting to push and make things happen, because I learned that that really isn't good for me. I don't think it's good for anyone, that pushing energy. And I'm really trying to be so thoughtful about what I'm thinking, what my beliefs are, what's causing me pain, emotional, what is causing me to be happier. And I'm doing more of that for sure. And so this week is about forgiving God. And, you know, what your beliefs are. In the lesson the first day of the week, it was about identifying your judgments about God. You know, sometimes it's easy, like it's easy to be on a diet when you're not hungry. Sometimes it's easier to believe there's a God when things are going well in our lives. And so I know everybody has different opinions. This is my page. This is my group. And I've struggled, certainly have struggled with thinking there was a God. Not right now as much as, because I dealt with it so much when my mother was murdered, that thank God, that's ironic, I feel like I have a foundation, whereas before my mother was killed, I didn't think there was a God, but I didn't have much opinion about God because I wasn't brought up religiously. My parents said there was a God. I only thought about how, you know, I went to temple. I was Jewish. I went to temple growing up on the High Holy Days. Didn't really mean anything to me. I didn't understand Hebrew. When my father would cheat about every 10 years on my mother and they would break up and get back together, I know he'd be going to temple and he'd be praying, and I didn't really understand that. I didn't understand why he didn't go before, you know, before he cheated. Like, how about asking God to help you before then? And I certainly have had times in my life where I prayed to God when I was thinking about doing something that was morally not in alignment with who I am or in integrity. I prayed to God, help me, give me strength. And I feel like that is something that we can always do when we need clarity. But for me, it's like it could be God. It's not some father image, certainly not some white father image in the sky. God, to me, is an energy of good that moves in and through all things, including me. So I am a part of that goodness. And it's not God-fearing, and it's not like I'm not a part of it, that I know that I can just go within and get silent. And when I do, I have access to that energy. Okay, so she's asking if she can see the live stream. She has to go to the page. Let me just say that. Go to the page. I wonder how many people have challenges with technology. I know I have some challenges for sure. So it's kind of funny when people ask me for help with technology. Go to the page. And I don't know what else to say. And you'll see it, hopefully. You'll see it live now. Okay. Okay. All right, so let's see, what else did I want to say? That feeling of God being within me, and in everybody else. I feel like sometimes people can't access that God energy just because they don't understand that they're a part of this magnificent energy that moves in and through everything. And so when things are hard, we question God, or depending on how we brought up, we can question God. I feel in some ways I didn't have that whole thing of like being a recovering Jew or a recovering Catholic. I hear it all the time from my friends who grew up in religion that they they had to separate and learn their own way versus what was put upon them. And I think that's with everything in life. How much are we like hypnotized into believing the way we believe because we've heard it so much growing up, or society is the way it is? I mean, I even say that with my sexuality. I'm bisexual. Didn't know I was. I'd say I'd lean more to heterosexual. But I feel like because I was with a woman 13 years, everyone else has been men. But I feel like I didn't know I was bi, partly because society is heterosexual, right? So if everywhere I go is heterosexual and all the magazines are men and women kissing and I like men, why would I even think that I'm bisexual? It took me like just being a grown woman and falling in love with someone to realize that. But I feel like partly that's because society is so heterosexual and other things, right? So thank you. So I also feel like with all our beliefs, what has been like, where have we been brainwashed about what spirit is, what God is, what something bigger than us is, what political party we are, where are we brainwashed and where is it really us deciding what works for us as adults? You know what I'm saying? So I don't impose my thoughts about God on anyone, but I say that it works for me to know there's something bigger. And I spoke yesterday about this, that I had a direct experience of God, source, whatever it is, after my mom died. And I also think that sometimes our ego and our mind is so powerful that we have to be completely, like, almost broken open before we'll accept something bigger than us, you know, and trying to control things. Cliff says, you had a husband guy for how many years? Husband guy. I was with my wife for 13 years. I had a fiance that was a man for 3.5 years, and I've had boyfriends for the rest of my life. And I didn't meet my wife until I was like 33. There you go, in the sexuality. So, yeah. But how much are we hypnotized in our life? By, you know, how much do we, how much are we open to thinking there is something bigger that moves in and through everything that is good? Right now, if I believed in a God-fearing God or a punishing one, man, this would not be a good time. This would be a worse time than it is right now. Because I would see evidence for my beliefs. That's what we do. We see evidence for our beliefs. So if I believe in either no God, if I believe in no God, I believe in using what works for me and using what works for you. If I believe there's no God, then it's going to be pretty damn scary right now. If I believe there's a God that punishes, I'm going to see evidence for, look how people are being punished. If I believe in a good God, I'm going to say, okay, where's the compassion? Where are the heroes? Where am I seeing people feed people and help people that are in need? And that's what I focus on. And that lifts my vibration. And that's what's so important right now, to lift our vibrations so that we're healthy. At the very least, so that we're healthy, or the very most, we're healthy. Literally keeping our immune system up. I get so passionate pretty much about a lot of things. One is like making choices that make us feel powerful. And sometimes we don't, you know, if we don't believe in the God that our family believed in, we get ostracized. Or if we don't, or if we believe something as simple as meditation and your family doesn't believe in it, then they might judge you as woo-woo. So we have to not care what other people are judging us feel. And that's why all of my forgiveness work is about self-forgiveness, so we can make self-honoring choices and setting very healthy boundaries so that people can have their opinions. They don't have to agree, absolutely not, but I'll share what I share so that if someone listens to what I say and says, huh, that might help me, then I know that I've touched someone and made someone's life better. And if they don't agree with me, so be it. That's fine too. You don't have to agree with me. We're all different. But what I'm saying for me is that I learned that when I lived through the most devastating thing of my father killing my mother and then marrying her sister, it was this direct experience with a power bigger than me that helped me get through it. And I had no experience with that beforehand. And so a lot of people have gone through, you know, those moments where you think you're completely broken. And in some ways, that moment breaks us open to feel something bigger than us. You know, feel something bigger than us. That if we understand, or how I understand it, is that that's good. That is a good force. And it's, yesterday I talked about, well, how can God be good when all these terrible things happen? But I talked about it yesterday, so I'm not going to talk about it today. But I don't have the answers. What I understand is that, you know, it's humans that make decisions. Or like right now, there's this virus, that's not God. Or that God is neutral. But I see it's neutral, and yet I see it through a lens of good. And when I see life through a lens of good, it means my focus is on helping. My focus is on loving. My focus is on compassion. And I know that right after my mom died, it's not like I was like, oh yes, everything's good. No, I don't even say to dismiss your feelings of fear or anger. I actually teach about embracing those feelings, but in a very conscious way where you're not hurting yourself or someone else. Because if we don't embrace our fear or our anger, it leaks out in our relationships. It leaks out, and I've talked about this, in addictions, overwork. Look at this. How many of us have been overworking, certainly with how everything was speeding up, not having time to think, and now all of a sudden we got time to think. And it'd be interesting to see how many people are just filling their time up with other things so they don't have to actually be with themselves. Well, what I teach and what I hope you guys have gotten out of Phoenix Rising, which is this 30 Days of Forgiveness, I put my program that is $222. I made it free for these 30 days. I hope what you're getting is that, oh, I just totally lost my train of thought, but I don't know what I said, but waiting for it to come back to me. That life, well, here's the thing. The outer world is a reflection of our inner reality. So you can look at life as not being for you, or you can look at, oh, now I'm thinking of that, what John Kennedy quote, you know, it's not what the country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. It might be not the country, but it's like not what the world can do or is doing, but what can I do? And we have more in our power. And when I wasn't believing there was a God, my life was shitty. Oh, this is what I was going to say. If you don't embrace your anger or your sadness, it will show up in other areas. It will leak out. And so now, yes, we are all alone with ourselves, and we have an opportunity to look at our judgments. And I think most people don't look at our judgments against others or ourselves because we're afraid we're going to beat the shit out of ourselves. And what I teach is how to love yourself, despite feeling like you've done so much wrong, and using discernment and setting healthy boundaries. Setting healthy boundaries is really, really important as well. I totally lost what I was... I'm going to listen to this back and hope this makes sense, because I lost that. I lost exactly what I was going to say right there. Let's see. Any other questions? Hey, Kristen. She made it. Yay. Yay. So, yeah. These are my thoughts. We have an opportunity to look at life, create the life how we want to see it, and what your beliefs are going to reflect back to you in the world. Like I said, so if you can hold on to that there is something good here and there's something bigger, then maybe you'll start seeing all that good news. Thank you. Because when we're in fear and when we're in just, you know, doing what we do without thinking,
it's really hard to find that part of us that's bigger, because it's squashed in with all these thoughts and these judgments and negativity. But when you release that, there's a space for more good to come in, and more thoughts, more opportunities that weren't even there before because you didn't have the space to receive them. Right? Hey, Kai, how are you? So good to see you. Sending love to you. So if you have any thoughts about this, pop it in here. This is a conversation. And I like to keep things uplifted without denying that there's anger, but I teach a very specific process that was in the lessons that you guys got to your inbox if you signed up for this, about freeform writing, so that you can take responsibility for your anger, your upset, your fear, your rage. Like, these are all things I had in my personal story, but I learned from going to a 2-year master's program in spiritual psychology, I learned how to channel my anger in a healthy way so that I wasn't taking it out on myself and I wasn't dumping it on other people. So I don't say don't have those feelings and that anger. Yes, don't skip over it, because when I skipped over it, you know what I did? I overate and I overworked out. So I gained weight, then I'd lose weight with working out, and then I'd injure myself because I was working out too much, and it was a vicious cycle, and then I would beat the shit out of myself. And the other thing with that was part of that process is that, and look at it for you, what do you do? Because I was overeating, I would gain weight, and then I would beat the shit out of myself. This is where I say, maybe you think you're not judgmental of others. Well, how judgmental are you of yourself? I would beat the shit out of myself for gaining weight. Like, horribly. But here's the thing. I didn't want to think about the real thing, and that's why I did that. And this was all unconscious at the time. I didn't want to think about the fact that my father, who I love so much, killed my mother, who I love so much. So instead, I created an addiction and a habit that made me not think about that. But then I ended up beating the shit out of myself because I was doing something bad to myself, but not dealing with the real issue. The real healing came when I dealt with the real issue, which was about my father and self-forgiveness. Forgiving myself for ever trusting him. And of course I would trust him. He was my father, but I had to forgive myself. I certainly wasn't even thinking at the place of, is there a God, back then? Because I was so caught in my story and my beating myself up. That's why self-forgiveness is the foundation of my work, because we can't even get out of ourselves or accept the help from something bigger than us if we're in our story and repeating our story and talking about the story from the level of the hurt versus the level of the healing. So I invite you to look at, what are your thoughts about God? And I'm not giving you the lessons here, because the lessons go to the inbox. Everybody who signs up today still gets this week's lessons on forgiving God. I invite you to look at your judgments so that you can reframe them to be affirmations that help you, not dismissing, like, you know, I forgave my dad, but I didn't then say, oh, and he's such a great person, I'm going to hang out with him. No, I took him to court for wrongful death and ended up not seeing him again, but from a place of self-honor versus punishment. Okay? All right. That's what I have to say today. Thank you so much for spending some time with me. At the end of this, I think we're on day 23. I think there's actually 31 lessons, not 30. I pretty much always deliver as much as I can. I'll be putting it back on sale. The program's $222, and I'll probably be doing a pay what you can that starts at like $22 or something like that, because I want these lessons in your hands. And probably an option to, you know, give me a tip or pay anywhere between there, so that I'm also, you know, valuing my business and being able to continue to go on in my business as well. Thank you so much for being here with me. And I'm going to sign off. If you have any questions, let me know. If you just want to say hello, that's fine. If you're watching the replay, let me know. If you haven't signed up for the 30 Days of Forgiveness with Brenda, when you sign up this week, even though we're already on day 23, you'll get all the lessons from this week, which are the lessons on forgiving God, to your inbox so that you can do the assignment each day. and hopefully that will help you. For those of you who want extra support, want coaching with me, where you can talk about things that you wouldn't do on social media, where you're also paying less than hiring me as a one-on-one coach, I invite you to join the Freedom Circle. The training for this month is already in there. We've done the coaching calls, but you can be in there and get the training, which is pretty extensive on raising your vibration. And we have a private group where you can ask questions. And then starting next month, we have a training on the first Friday of the month and then a group coaching on the third Friday of the month. That program's only $47 a month. It is a three-month program. And that's a place where I share certain stories, certain teachings that I also don't teach on public social media, right? Because we want to be able to be ourselves and share our story and everything like that, but you also want to know who your audience is, right? There's, you know, who knows who's going to, someone was on here the other day that I don't know, right? I'm not going to share my stuff or my client's stuff that is very personal and in a public place. But I absolutely will share anything I can that will help you as far as taking your questions. And I hope to see you tomorrow. Tomorrow we're back to 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for the live stream here. I'll be doing these on this page till the end of the 30 days of forgiveness with Brenda. So that's about another 7-8 days. And that's it. I hope this was helpful. Cliff says, have a good weekend. Thank you so much. I'm working this weekend with my second group of entrepreneurs who are getting online. Pretty exciting. So I get to teach acting skills and presentation skills and personal styling, which I love doing, and it's a lot of fun. So, and that starts tomorrow morning. But I will be on here at 1 tomorrow, and I'm pretty sure 1 p.m. on Sunday. Yeah, on Sunday too. 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Have a beautiful, blessed weekend. You're welcome, Kristen. I'm so happy to be working with you. And have a great day. Bye. Blessed day. Have a blessed day.